Are you losing potential customers or clients because you're missing the first email that they send you because of a messy inbox? In this video, I'll show you how to set up a simple automation that will label first-time email senders in your inbox. That way you can easily find people that have not emailed you before and make a timely response to them. My name is Andy O'Neill, and I help entrepreneurs like you add automation to their business. So here's an example of an email from someone who just emailed me for the first time. When this automation ran, it looked up this sender in my email history and found that there was only one email, and it was this email, which means they've sent to me for the very first time. So the label of first message was applied to this email, which makes it easier for me to find and respond to. We're going to build this automation with a platform called make.com. If you don't have a make.com account, click this link and you can get a free month of their core plan. And as always, if you need help with this automated scenario or any others, go to weblytica.com to get help from a make expert. So here's the scenario that we're going to build. It's only 3 modules long. That makes it pretty simple to build. There is a little bit of a complex step in here that we'll talk about in just a second. So I'm in my Make account and I'm going to click Create New Scenario right here. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to rename this. Next thing we need to do is we need to get the Gmail Watch Emails module. Now Gmail's right here, but I'm going to show you how to find that in case it's not in that list. You just go right down here to Search Apps or Modules and type Gmail, and then click on the top bar here, and this will show all of the available options for Gmail. And we're going to use the Watch Emails trigger. For the folder, we're going to choose the Inbox. And then for filter type, I'm going to do a Gmail filter. And then I'm going to put in here category primary. And what that means is this is only going to return emails that land in my primary tab of Gmail. I really don't want to run this for newsletters and subscriptions or forum updates or those kind of things. I just want to run this when it's most likely a human emailing me, so I can see if they've emailed me in the past and I can mark them as a new sender if they haven't. Mark email messages when read. I'm going to leave that as no, and I'm going to change my number here to 50. This number is the maximum number of emails that will be retrieved when this runs. And this also depends on how often you run the scenario. If you run it every 15 minutes, 50 might be too many. You just want to make sure this is high enough that when it runs, it's getting all of the new emails and processing them. So the maximum number of results, this works for me. I'm going to put that at 50. And now it wants to know where we want to start. And so I'm going to just say for now, I'm going to say from now on. And I'm going to show you how to change this to test to make sure this is working on your system. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to add an HTTP module. We're going to scroll down here to make an OAuth 2.0 request. Now you will need to connect your Make account to your Gmail OAuth 2, and there's some steps to do that. And right here is a link to the documentation on how to set that up. So now I need to put a URL in here, and I'm going to paste the URL for my scenario that I already built. And let's look at what this means. gmail.googleapis.com/gmail/v1users. And then right here is the email address for the account I want to check. You're going to obviously need to put your email address in here. And our query is from : and then the email address of the sender right down here. If we went over to my inbox and search for from : and this email address, it's going to list all the emails that I've received from that email. We're doing the same thing here. And this is going to be a GET request, and you don't have to do anything else down here. You can parse response. Yes, that needs to be turned on, and hit OK. Let me right click on this. I'm going to say choose where to start. I'm going to say select first email. And again, this will process up to 50 emails. I'm just going to go down here a few and hit OK and run this. So for each email it finds, it's going to look up and see how many email messages are in my inbox that have been sent to me from this email. So let's pick one of these here. Here is an email, hello@buffer.com. So if we go down here to the data, we can see the result estimate, result size estimate is 201. That means I've received 201 messages from hello@buffer.com. Right here is a list of emails, or at least the first 100 emails, but we don't really need that. We just need this number right here. So what we're looking for is an email that we get where the result size estimate is 1. Meaning they can only find one email from this particular sender. So this is working correctly. Now what we're going to do is we're going to add another Gmail module, and we're going to type modify, and we're looking for modify email labels. So what we're going to do here is we're going to add a filter. So right here we have our result size estimate, and on this one that came through it's 45. So this is a fairly new sender, but not brand new. We're going to put that right there. And then we're going to go down to our numeric values, and we're going to say numeric operators, it's equal to 1. Now, don't put 0 here because we actually have an email from them. We're looking for someone who has sent us 1 email. So when this runs, it's only going to let these through that has 1 in this estimate size. So here's the one that has 45. So when this equals 1, then this is going to run this final step and add the label. So I'm going to go in here to my labels. And so we have to map the Gmail message ID so that Mate can match up and put the label change on the right email. So we're going to go over here and we're going to scroll down. Gmail message ID is right down here. And then we're going to add a label to our email. So what we're going to do is we're going to scroll down here and look for first message and check that. So when we find a sender that only has 1 email in our email system or email inbox, it's going to allow it to go through this filter. It's going to update the label for the Gmail message ID. Now, the nice thing about this module is it's going to add the label. It's not going to overwrite the label. So if you have other labels on this message for some reason, this is just going to add to that. It should not remove those other labels. So I'm going to click OK, and we're going to save this. All right, so one last thing we're going to do. In the event this email has been deleted or moved, we want to right-click here and add some error handling. So in this case, we're going to say ignore, which will mean it just ignores the error and moves on. So the last thing we need to do is set up the scheduling for this scenario. Before we do that, I would just say if you like content like this, please hit the thumbs up button and consider subscribing for future videos. Right down here is our scheduling. And by default, Make's going to schedule this every 15 minutes, which is probably more often than we want that to happen. So let's say 60 minutes, and then I'm going to set up some advanced scheduling. And now what that means is I want to run this Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Those are the days I work typically. And then I want to start this at 8 o'clock a.m. and I want it to run until 6 o'clock p.m. So this is going to save us operations because it's not going to be running all night long while I'm sleeping or while I'm off doing things with my family on the weekend. This is just going to run during the normal hours. So if anything comes in during the weekend, it'll get caught up on Monday morning when this runs. Thank you for watching. And if you want to learn more about how to manage labels with Gmail, check out this playlist. And thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.